Dear students, in this module, which focuses on district-wise population projections, let us discuss about how the projections can be made at a district level, especially by using component method of population projection. So, the learning objectives are district-wise population projections, component method, and the components of mortality, fertility, and migration. Population projections relates to the projection of population of future dates following the last census, usually future dates for which no current reports are available. Population projections are essentially concerned with the future growth of population. They may be prepared for the total population of nations, their principal geographic subdivisions or specific localities within them. The principal characteristics for which projections need to be made are age and sex distribution, and the method by which one can make such projections, especially it is the component method. Let us discuss about component method in detail. Population growth of an area is a dynamic function of three components, usually the vital rates like fertility, mortality, and migration. The component method makes explicit assumptions regarding each of the above three components of population growth, and hence can give a considerable amount of insights into the way population changes over a period of time. In component method, the computations are carried out separately for age sex groups on the basis of separate allowances for each of the above components. In the present module, component method is used to project the population by age and sex for all the districts of Andhra Pradesh state except a West Godavari district till the year 2001 AD. The projections are made for the two quinquennia, that is 1995 to 96 and 2000 to 2001, based on the 1991 census population figures, which is used in the data. The method also requires a detailed information about fertility, mortality, and migration data. A detailed account of the base level data used is as below. Age and sex structure of the population. Provisional population totals from 1991 census were used as the base level data. Since age-wise data is not yet published at that time, it was obtained from the estimated percentage distribution of population of the state. Mortality data. Child mortality estimate of each district of 1981 census were used to obtain the death rate for 0 to 4 age groups, and the specific death rates of male and females were available at the state level from SRS 1987 were used for the rest of the age groups and as presented in table 1. A specific death rates in Andhra Pradesh 1987 was presented across different age groups and male and female, the population distribution of in terms of percentages are also presented. In the case of fertility data, the general fertility rate of Andhra Pradesh from SRS for the year 1987 is used as the base for all the districts, since the data is not available at the district level at that time. The general fertility rates are divided by the assumed proportion of married female population for the year 1987 at the district level to obtain general marital fertility rates for each district for the year 1987. Let us discuss about the migration data. From 1981 migration tables, that is the source available D13 place of birth statistics, net migrants were calculated for each district. The percentage of net migrants to total population were given in table 2. Since these percentages are very small, excepting Hyderabad, Rangareddy, Nizamabad and Khammam districts, the impact of migration on population growth may not be very significant, and hence the component of migration is not considered in population projections. In 1981 census, 13.9% in Hyderabad district and 23.2% in Rangareddy districts are the migrants based on the place of last residence or population, indicating that migration is an important contributory factor in the growth of population of these two districts. Hence, to the total projected population of Hyderabad and Rangareddy districts, a certain amount of migration has to be added. Since the migration component, inter-district migration, is not significant for others, there are two major aspects to deal with, that is, one, obtaining future survival ratios for two quinquennia from the age-specific death rates of the base year, and two, calculation of future births for the two quinquennia from the GFR of the base year. There are different steps in obtaining survival ratios. Let us discuss in detail each step. Step 1, construction of life table for the base year, starting with the age-specific death rates of males and females from SRS. Age-specific death rates is equal to the number of deaths is in an age group by population of that age group multiplied by 1000 as a constant. NMX is equal to ASDR by 1000. Using the above N power M to the base X values, the other columns of the life table are constructed as usual except the N power QX values. NQX is equal to 2NMX by 2 plus NMX. The table clearly reveals the district-wise, gender-wise population over a period of time. Number 2. In the step 2, the assumptions regarding mortality, starting with SR's life tables for a particular year, it has been assumed that the annual increase in E00, that is life expectancy at birth, would be 0.6 years for males in that district whose base is E00 is equal to 50 to 59.9 years, 0 to 4 years whose base is E00 that is equal to 60 to 64.9 years during the period 1987 to 2000. The respective increase in E00 for females is 0.65 and 0.45 years per annum. Thus, assume different E00 for different quinquennia can be obtained. Let us discuss about step 3, construction of life tables for quinquennia. Life tables constructed for 95 to 96 to 2000 to 2000 using NMX to the BX base and NQX values derived from step 2. From these life tables, life expectancy at birth E00 values are derived for the two quinquennia. There is a difference between assumed and derived values. These two have to be converged by iterative procedure. In the step 2 or step 4, iterative procedure is discussed. This procedure is used to converge derived life expectancy at birth E00 with the help of a computer, assuming that there will be 1% increase in NQX values. The NQX values after iteration for the two quinquennia are used to get the survival ratios, that is 1 minus NQX. These survival ratios are used to project the future population, and the same the table across different districts, male and female population over a period of time are presented in detail. Obtaining future birth is another step which we require. there are 4 steps to get the future births. Step 1, assumption that regarding the future married females population, the general fertility rate of Andhra Pradesh for the year 1987 from sample registration system is used as the base, as the district wise rates are not available. It was assumed that the proportion of married females to total females in the age group 15 to 44 years observed in the past decades would continue till the year 2001, that is presented in table 5. The figures for 1947 were calculated by interpolation. For all the districts, the general fertility rate of the state level is divided by the proportion of married 1987 to get the general marital fertility rate values and presented in table 6, which clearly reveal the district wise for a period of time the rate how it is distributed across these districts. In step 2, assumption regarding fertility. Couple protection rates from 1980 to 1990 to 91 were noted for all the districts from the Directorate of Health and Family Welfare, Andhra Pradesh State. 3 assumptions were made with regard to future fertility. Number 1, all the districts will achieve 60% couple protection rate by the year 2001 AD. Number 2, the districts with the current level of couple protection rate would achieve the following levels by 2001 AD, that is less than 30%, 30.1 to 35.0, that is 36%, 35.1 to 40.20, 42, 40.1 to 45.0, 53, 45.1 to 53.0, it is 60. The average annual increase, that is actual in coupled protection rate in the past, would continue in future till 2001 AD. In step 3, conversion of CPRs into GMFRs. The likely levels of GMFRs for future years have been calculated on the assumption that there will be a gap of 1 year between couples effectively protected and fall in fertility. The value of GMFR for a particular year has been calculated as GMFR of T is equal to GMFR of 1987 multiplied by 1 minus proportion of couples protected in T minus 1 years, divided by 1 minus proportion of couples protected in the year 1986. Thus, the GMFRs for future years, that is 1996 and 2001, were calculated based on the likely of futures couple protection rates under the above 3 assumptions, and the necessary data are presented in the table 6. In step 4, they calculated from of births. The births are calculated from the GMFRs using the following formula. Total births is equal to general marital fertility rate into female population in the age group of 15 to 44 years and multiplied by assumed population of married females in the age group of 15 to 44 years. Male births is equal to total births multiplied by 105 by 205. Female births is equal to total births multiplied by 100 divided by 205. Let us discuss in detail about the methods of population projections that is used. The 1991 age and sex data of each district is usually considered as the base level data. The population in each age group is multiplied with the corresponding survival ratios to get the population of the next age group for the next interval, that is in the year 1995 to 96. Thus, the population of each age group in each interval is obtained. The female population of 0 to 4 years in 1995 to 96 have been calculated as the number of female births multiplied by survival ratio of 0 to 4 years in the age group and the year 1995 to 96. Similar procedure is used for calculating female population in the age group of 0 to 4 years for the interval of year 2000 to 2001. Thus, population projections are made for all districts up to 2001 data. The projected population figures by age and sex are given in table 7. Let's discuss about annual growth rates. Annual growth rates are calculated for each district. The data of table number 7 indicate that Srikakulam, Visakhapatnam, East Godavari, Krishna, Nellur, Kadapa, Karnool, Khammam, Adilabad, Nizamabad, Rangareddy and Hyderabad districts have shown more growth rate than the state as a whole, and it is an assumption that has been used. The annual growth rates of all the districts have to be reduced to a greater extent from 1981 to 91 decadal annual growth rates to achieve the couple protection rates of 60 by 2001 AD. To achieve this, a lot of effort has to be put in the family planning program and maternal and child health status, particularly in the districts of Medak, Adilabad, Nalgonda, Warangal, Khammam, Anantapur and Karnool. In the districts of Hyderabad, Rangareddy, migration contributes a major part of the growth rate. So, one has to make special efforts to reduce it by providing industrial development and educational facilities as well in other neighboring districts. Thus, it is very clear that by considering a case study of Andhra Pradesh at a district level data and by using the component method where the assumptions and the projections of population by considering the three major components of population growth, that is fertility, mortality and migration, have been considered, and each of these districts in the state have been projected, and the data clearly brings out the fact that each of the districts, depending on the level of development of each state, each district within the state, the projections are very well reflected, as some of these districts are industrially developed, socially advanced, and also the achievement of family planning program in those districts are specifically varying across these districts, and thereby the projections when it is made at a district level brings out the fact that the population projections varies with respect to each of these districts and also across the different districts of the state. And the results clearly reveal that the assumptions with regard to each of these components should be realistic and to the expectation, so that if proper projections are made with a good understanding of the situations in the development across different dimensions, it will be more realistic. The projections also for future years gives a good clarity about the way in which each of these districts are heading over a period of time. And the component method has a very important advantage compared to the other method, mainly because the dynamics in the population growth, that is reflected through fertility, mortality, migration. Unless we take each of these components and with certain assumptions, if we make the projections, they are more realistic, and also the planning of at a district level will be much more very distinct and also realistic over a period of time. And in this context, as a case study, the data clearly has been shown that how the projections have contributed in understanding the districts, the progress of these districts over a period of time, at the same time the progress also in not only in reducing the fertility and mortality aspects or achieving through family planning programs, but also in the overall development, how it has been. The table 1 clearly reveals that age specific death rates that are experienced at the state level in the year 1987. The source was sample registration system of 1987, and the table clearly depicts the different age groups starting from 0 to 4, 5 to 9, 10 to 4, 10 to 14, 15 to 19, 20 to 24, up to 65 to 69 and 70 plus, and the distribution with respect to male and female is shown. The age specific death rate in the 0 to 4 years is very high in both the gender groups, that is in male 29.2 and in female 24.8, and in the next age group of 5 to 9 it is as low as 2.1 and 2.9 respectively among male and female, and 10 to 14 years it is 1.4 and 1.5 respectively, and it slowly increases and further increases up to 45 to 49 years, where male age specific death rate is 8.9, and in the case of females it is 6.6, and in the 50 to 54 years it is 14.8 and 10.1 respectively among male and females, and further increases to 19.4 years and 14.9 years in the case of male and female in the age group of 55 to 59, and in the elderly age groups of 60 to 64, males age specific death rate is 38, and in the case of females 27.9 years, and in the next higher level of 65 to 69 years, the male age specific death rate is 46.6 and 37.67 in the case of male and female, and in the highest age group of 70 plus years, the age specific death rate among male is 112.9 and in the case of females 90.1. Across all age groups, age specific death rate is shown as 10.4 among males and 9.4 among females. In the case of table 3, the expectation of life at birth for the base year and the assumed figures for the future has been presented across different districts in the state, and the table clearly indicates that the life at birth expectation of life at birth across each of these years between male and female has been shown to be, like from 1987 to 1991 and 1996 and 2001, and the distribution clearly reveals the huge variations across districts in this state. And in the table 4, which is presented the derived expectation of life at birth for two quinquennia, that is 1996 and 2001, again presented male and female wise across different districts, also reflects a huge variations that exists across districts in the reference periods. And in the next table, that is table 5, the proportion of married females in the age group of 15 to 44 years in the past and the expected values of the future also presented, and in each year between 1961, 71, 81, 87, 1981, 96 and 2001, again with respect to each district of the state, also clearly mentioned and presented, which clearly indicates the huge variations that exist in this